So, girls, what we are going to do today? Today we are going to keep working in the past simple and past continuous. This is our last class of this topic. And we are going to have a practice activity, okay? And after that, we are going to have a game for a speaking activity, okay? So let's start with the practice. And after that, we are going to continue with the speaking activity. So I'm going to show you here my screen, just give me a second. Okay, here we have it. I'm going to share this with you. Okay, girls, can you see my screen?
Yes, Tisha.
Okay, perfect. So here we have it. This is the practice activity we have for today. And I'm going to remember you or to remind you what for do we use the past continuous tense. So here we have like the grammar, okay, for forming the past continuous tense. We use the verb to be, right? Was not or were not. Plus the ing, right? This one. Form of the verb. Like reading, watching, this one you already know. But here we have some exceptions, right? We don't use these tenses with these verbs. Entonces, aquí tenemos una excepción que quiero que recuerden. Esto ya lo vimos hace mucho tiempo, pero quiero que lo vuelvan y lo recuerden. Con estos verbos que tengo aquí subrayados, que está la chica pensando, ¿cierto? No podemos utilizar el presente continuo, ¿ok? Con estos de acá, voy a ser bien enfática, estos que tenemos acá. Oops. Here we have them. Like, love, hate, smell, seem, believe, understand, realize, belong, know, want, need, depend, suppose, and some others, okay? Estos se llaman los state verbs o los verbos para estado, ¿sí? Que dicen cómo estamos de algo, el estado de ánimo, o también están los verbos de los sentidos, okay? Entonces, con esos verbos no podemos utilizar el gerundio, que es el ing, ¿ok? La terminación en ing. Perfect. So now let's continue with the activity. So what we're going to do, girls, we're going to fill the spaces, right, the blanks, with the correct form of the past continuous tense, ¿ok? With the verbs in the brackets. So here we have not paint. So we're going to put it in the past continuous tense. Okay? So, ¿cómo quedaría la número uno, Yoka? It says, you the walls of his house yesterday. Not paint. ¿Cómo quedaría?
You didn't paint the walls of the house?
Didn't paint it or weren't? Look at this.
Okay, filling the sentence in color of the verb in the past continuous. Entonces aquí sería, where weren't?
Ajá. You.
Dice, y cómo por ejemplo, yo estoy leyendo esto, y cómo aquí yo sé que no es did. Es where, ¿cómo diferencia?
Okay. Bueno, en este caso estamos trabajando este tiempo, ¿cierto? Que es pasado continuo. Entonces, en este caso no utilizarías el didn't. Pero, no estoy diciendo que si tú pones ahí, you didn't paint the walls of this house yesterday, está mal. No, está bien. Pero en este momento no estamos trabajando ese tiempo, ¿ok? Ok. O sea, este ya no es una comparación, este ya es un refuerzo para el pasado continuo, que fue que comenzamos viendo y luego lo comparamos, ¿cierto? Lo comparamos con el pasado simple que ya vimos también. Pero entonces este ya es un refuerzo final para el pasado continuo nada más, ¿ok?
Ok. Then, you weren't painting the word of the how yesterday.
So you weren't paint or painting?
You were painting.
Uh-huh, perfect. You weren't painting. Very good. The walls of his house yesterday. Number two, Rocio. It says, Mavis, a horse when she broke her arm. ¿Cómo decimos que ella no estaba montando caballo?
Wasn't? Wasn't reading?
Yes, perfect. Wasn't reading.
Okay, teacher.
Wasn't reading a horse. Wasn't riding a horse. Number three, Sus Lady. It says, the two men not carry. ¿Cómo lo completaríamos, Sus Lady? Oh, Sus Lady is not here. Okay, go ahead, Yoka.
The two men weren't carrying half boxes yesterday.
Weren't carrying, perfect. Heavy boxes yesterday. Sus Lady, are you back? Sus Lady is here now?
No. Ella vino, pero se acaba de ir. Otra vez. Oh.
Okay. Number four, Rocio, go ahead. When you wake up me. Wake me up.
I wasn't. Dreaming.
When you wake me up. Perfect. I wasn't dreaming when you woke me up here. Very good. Number five, Yoka. It says Larry, his teeth at 7 yesterday.
Teacher, Sus Lady is here now.
Okay, perfect. Sus Lady, tienes buena conexión, ¿me escuchas?
Sí, teacher, disculpa, es que como estoy desde el celular no lo manejo, entonces voy a de pronto activar el micrófono y me salgo, pero disculpa,
ya aprendido.
Ok, bien.
Ok, perfecto. So, Sus Lady, estamos trabajando solamente el pasado continuo, ¿ok? Para poder pasar al siguiente tema, ¿listo? Para que esto ya nos quede full para seguir avanzando, ¿ok? Entonces estamos completando las oraciones con la forma en pasado continuo. Entonces por acá tienes estos tres ejemplos. Dice, you weren't painting the walls of his house yesterday. Y los verbos que nos da, el verbo que nos dan entre paréntesis era paint y en negación. Entonces, eso quería decir que tenemos que usar la negación del verbo to be en pasado más el verbo paint más ing. ¿Ok? Entonces, okay. ¿Me puedes ayudar a hacer las cinco? Dice, Larry, his teeth at 7 yesterday. Y tenemos que es negación también. El verbo es clean.
Ok. Larry.
Ajá.
Wasn't. Cleaning
his teeth
at 7 yesterday.
Very good. Larry wasn't cleaning his teeth at 7 yesterday. Perfect. So now number 6, Yoka. It says, yeah. They, when I came in.
They weren't working when I came in.
Perfect. They weren't working when I came in. Perfect. Number 7, Rocio.
The dog wasn't sleeping on the bed last night.
Very good. The dog wasn't sleeping on the bed last night. Number eight, Sus Lady.
Mr. Green wasn't.
Perfect.
My hair at 7 yesterday.
At 5.
At 5.
Yes, very good. So Mr. Green wasn't cutting my hair at 5 yesterday.
Okay.
Number 9, Yoka.
It wasn't getting cold when I closed the window.
Perfect. It wasn't getting cold when I closed the window. Very good. Very good. Number 10, Rocio.
The family weren't having the lunch when the postman came.
Perfect. Pero aquí entonces es wasn't, no weren't, ¿ok? Porque los sujetos que son, por ejemplo, como familia o todos, los conjugamos cuando decimos the family or everybody, los conjugamos como si fueran singulares, ¿ok? Como si fueran tercera
okay,
persona.
Teacher.
Perfecto. Yes.
You can read the number 9, please. It's
yes.
In Spanish.
Ok. No estaba haciendo frío cuando cerré la ventana. It wasn't getting cold when I closed the window.
O sea, no estaba haciendo frío. Getting.
Ajá, getting cold. Bueno, getting ahí no es literal haciendo. Ok. Porque, o sea, el frío no se puede hacer. O sea, nosotros no podemos hacer el frío. Sí. Uh-huh. El frío ya es una condición natural. Entonces, por eso no se puede decir making cold, sino getting. Getting es porque estaba haciendo frío, pero no venía de nosotros, sino de esta, de la condición natural, ¿ok?
Okay.
Literalmente, getting es como obtener, ¿ok? Pero entonces ahí no sería obtener, sino de hacerse.
Por eso cuando intenté como leerla en español, porque eso es lo que hago, la leo en español, para ver si pues para entender. Entonces cuando decía getting, como que me confunde un poco ahí, porque yo estaba leyendo. El getting como que me devolvía total, o sea, me confundí.
Exacto, sí, porque ahí no es literal obtener, ¿okay? No es obteniendo frío, sino que está haciendo frío. Pero como nosotros el frío no lo podemos hacer, o sea, es una condición natural, entonces por eso es getting, es como...
I got it.
Exacto, la combinación de los dos ya como enfriando, ¿verdad? Ese significado. Perfect. So now we are going to pass to task two. And what we are going to do here is that we are going to use the word that you give us, okay? And we are going to put it in past continuous, okay? So, like the example, it says, I not write a letter while you read. Entonces, I wasn't writing a letter while you were reading. Entonces, acá vamos a hacer eso. ¿Listo? Vamos a copiar o vamos a acomodar la oración. La vamos a organizar colocando los verbos que nos dan. Por ejemplo, aquí está. Not learn and cook en pasado continuo. ¿Ok? So, number one. Esta la vamos a hacer como ejemplo también. Entonces, dice... They not learn while their mom cook. So it would be
they weren't learning
while their mom was cooking, right? Perfect. They were learning while their mom was cooking. Very good. So now number two. We're going to do number two. It says, while his tooth waits, John not eat anything. So Daniela, how would be that? ¿Cómo sería esa, Dani?
John wasn't.
John wasn't
eating. Anything?
Anything?
While? I don't know.
Okay, aquí tenemos que identificar cuál es el verbo. Entonces, his tooth sería el sujeto, ¿cierto? Y ache, do you know what is ache? ¿Saben qué es ache?
No.
No, teacher.
Okay, ache es doler. Okay. Ese dolor de muelas. No sé si ustedes han visto que dicen headache. Voy a ponérselos por acá al ladito. Headache.
Sí, es el que yo conozco. Headache.
Ajá. Headache es dolor de cabeza. Okay. Toothache. Es dolor de muela. Ajá, dolor de muela. Stomach ache.
Dolor de estómago.
Ajá. Stomach ache. No es estómago chache, sino stomach ache. Ok. Entonces, ache es el verbo doler en este caso. Entonces aquí sería aching. So, John wasn't eating anything while his tooth was aching. Okay. While his tooth sino que no se ve casi porque esta abuelita casi no nos deja ver, pero aquí ya está. John wasn't eating anything while his tooth was aching. Ok, estaba doliendo mientras su diente le estaba doliendo. Number three, Sus Lady. ¿Cómo quedaría la número 3? Sus Lady.
Hi, I'm here, teacher.
Okay.
Esto.
Number 3, la número 3. ¿Cómo quedaría?
Wasn't asked to move. No nos sale
the policeman.
Okay, question me.
Pero question me, ¿cómo quedaría ese question me?
Me preguntaba.
Me estaba preguntando, ¿cierto? ¿Y cómo sería? The policeman was, right?
Was me? Was question me? Questioning. Okay.
Ok, las dos van en pasado continuo porque estamos hablando de while, ok. Esta podría cambiar, esta podría ir en pasado simple. Pero las dos, esta tendría que ir en pasado continuo, sea como sea. Number four, Rocío.
The children weren't playing football while they were staying on the playground.
While they were staying on the playground. Perfect. Very good. So now number five, Joka.
Esto es en presente, en pasado.
En pasado, recuerda que es en pasado, en pasado continuo.
I wasn't putting the box on the shelf.
I wasn't or I was.
I was putting the box on the shelf while you weren't doing anything.
Perfect. While you weren't doing anything. Very good. So now number six, Daniela. Can you help me? It says, Dad loves taking the medicine while mom has a shower.
Dad wasn't taking. The medicine while mom was having a shower.
Perfect. So Dad wasn't taking the medicine while mom was having a shower. Very good. So now number seven, Sus Lady, can you help me?
The cat wasn't drinking.
Any milk while they were
looking at
right?
¿Está bien?
Yes, perfect. The cat wasn't drinking any milk while they were looking at it. There it is. So now, number eight, Rocio.
You were driving home, it wasn't raining.
Perfect. While you were driving home, it wasn't raining. Very good. Now, number nine, it says, Mrs. Johnson, not shake. That this one is going to do it. Daniela. Dani?
Miss Johnson wasn't shaking.
Wasn't shaking.
Her emails while she gets babysit.
Babysit is Babysit es, ¿cómo se llama lo que hacen, por ejemplo,
la niñera?
Eso, niñera. Cuidar bebés, exacto. Niñera. Ok, babysitting. While she
was babysitting.
Ajá, perfect.
Little George.
Perfect. So very good. So now number 10, Yoka.
You weren't writing anything while the teacher was explaining the grammar.
Perfect. You weren't writing anything while the teacher was explaining very good, perfect. So now we're going to continue with the task number 3, okay? And what we're going to do, girls, we're going to write the correct form, it means the past continuous, of the verb one on the lines from the list, okay? Entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer, chicas? Vamos a leer estas oraciones, ¿ok? Y vamos a encontrar qué verbo, con qué negación van, ¿ok? Con cuál de estos va. Y lo vamos a conjugar en pasado continuo. So, for example, number one, it says, James to the news when Emma phoned him. Entonces, not buy, not fight, not listen, not make, not plan, not push, not scrap, said, think, or not wait. I think it is not listen. ¿Cómo quedaría la número uno con not listen? Rocío.
James wasn't listening to the news when Emma phoned him.
Perfect, very good. Entonces, James no estaba escuchando las noticias cuando Emma lo llamó. James wasn't listening to the news when Emma phoned him. Perfect. Number two, it says, my family for me when I arrived home. So, ¿con cuál? ¿Con cuál creen ustedes que deberíamos hacerlo? ¿Con qué verbo?
Wait.
Wait. So, let's see. Yoka, ¿cómo sería? My family was
waiting for me when I arrived home.
Okay, my family wasn't, okay, porque dice not wait. Wasn't waiting for me when I arrived home. Perfect. Very good. Number three, it says Joan of the solution when I ask her. ¿Con cuál creen que iría? Bye, fight. Do you know what is scrum?
No.
No, scrum, teacher.
Fregar.
Pensar.
Okay. Think. Very good. ¿Quién lo dijo, Dani? O sus lady. ¿Quién dijo think?
Sus ladies.
Ok, sus ladies, go ahead.
Sus ladies, mi persona.
Ok, so Joan.
Joan wasn't
thinking
of the solution. Thinking.
Of the solution when I asked her. Perfect. Joanne wasn't thinking of the solution when I asked her. Do you know what is thinking of?
Thinking
Pensando
en.
Pensando en la solución.
Ajá, very good. So perfect, it is think. Now, the number four, it says, they made the beds when Jake came in.
Wasn't making?
Aha, perfect. Wasn't making. Very good. So make, it's already here.
Then make.
Number five, it says, I the floor yesterday. Which one do you think? Buy, find, plan, push, scrub, set,
scrub.
Scrub.
Okay. I wasn't scrub the flowers yesterday.
Perfect. I wasn't scrub or scrubbing?
The scrubbing.
Perfect. I wasn't scrubbing the floor yesterday. Number six, it says
the
we weren't buying the
Christmas presents at 5 o'clock yesterday.
Very good. We weren't buying. Perfect. The next one, we have number seven. It says, and the table while mom was cooking lunch.
Annie wasn't sitting on the table while mom was cooking lunch.
Perfect. Set, very good. It's setting, arreglando, okay? La mesa, setting the table. Then we have number eight. Dave, anything when Joe asked him? Plan or push?
Push
or fight? We have three: fight, push, or plan.
David wasn't planning anything when Joe asked me.
Yes, very good. Dave wasn't planning anything. No estaba planeando nada. Dave wasn't planning anything when Joe asked him. Number nine, it says the two men when the police arrived. So the two men were what? We have fight or push.
The two men two men weren't fighting when the police arrived.
Very good. The two men weren't fighting when the police arrived. Perfect. So the last one is with Pooch, right? So let's do it. It says Sally
What is trolley, teacher?
Trolley is carretilla, okay? Sally wasn't pushing. Empujando la carretilla. When we met in the supermarket. It could be. También, no solamente puede ser carretilla, sino también carrito de mercado, ¿ok? Trolley. Aunque también es más común, shop cart, ¿ok? Shopping cart.
Yes, shopping
cart. Carrito de mercado. Perfect. Very good. We're going to leave it so far.
Teacher.
Yes.
Excuse me, ¿qué es Scrooge? Cuando su merced explicó, Bruno ladrón, no entendí.
Ok, Scrooge es fregar, ok, como lavar.
Ok, teacher, thank you.
You're welcome. Lo vamos a dejar hasta aquí para pasar a la otra actividad de speaking, ok. So, let's do it. I'm going to present to you the other activity. Okay, here we have it. Can you see my screen now, girl?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Perfect. So this is what we're going to do. This is a board game, okay? Es un juego para la pantalla, right? ¿Y qué vamos a hacer aquí? No vamos a tirar los dados porque, pues, eso ay, consume mucho tiempo y no es tan divertido. Entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Cada una va a hacerle una pregunta, ¿ok? A una compañera. Entonces, le va a decir, por ejemplo, bueno, una pregunta no, le va a dar un número a una compañera. Entonces, por ejemplo, Rocío puede decirle a Daniela, para Daniela le doy el número 5. So, Dani, number 5. Entonces, yo cuento 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Y donde caiga Daniela, pues, tendrá que acomodar la oración. Las oraciones, por ejemplo, aquí cayó Daniela. Supongamos que cayó en la número 5. Y las oraciones dicen, a monkey eats bananas while his friend cleans his fur. Entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer ahí? Como estamos viendo el pasado continuo, pues tenemos que conjugarlas en pasado continuo, ¿ok? Pero recuerden, cuando sea con while, va con pasado continuo. Si tenemos alguna que diga when, recuerden que con when sí va con pasado simple, ¿ok?
Okay.
Entonces, por ejemplo, esta número 5 quedaría, a monkey was eating bananas while his friend was cleaning his fur. Do you know what is fur?
No, teacher.
Pelaje, ok. Estaba limpiando su pelaje. Ok, perfect. So let's do it. Let's start with Sus Lady. Sus Lady, choose a classmate and choose a number. Sus Lady, escoge un compañero y un número.
No veo pantalla, teacher. ¿La quitaste?
No, yo estoy aquí. ¿No la ven, chicas?
Yes. I see it. Yo la veo.
Sus Lady, ¿ya la ves?
No, fin, teacher. Ahora sí. Ok.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
So, choose a number, dime un número y una persona.
Yoka.
Yes, Yoka.
Number 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It says 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. While tigers chase their prey, all the animals howl from fear. Do you know what is howl, Yoka?
No.
How is aullar, okay?
Okay.
So, okay. How would be? ¿Cómo sería?
Wild tigers.
Uh-huh. Wild tigers.
Tigers. Where?
Yes.
Where chasing their prey, all the animal.
Uh-huh.
Howling.
Ajá, where?
Howling. Okay. La where? Dije y no sé ni siquiera qué fue lo que dije. While tigers were chasing their prey, all the animals howling.
Were
howling from fear.
Very good. Do you know what is chase? Perseguir.
No. Chase, perseguir.
Y prey es presa. Okay.
Presa.
Ajá. Fear, pues es miedo. Entonces lo que dijiste fue que mientras los tigres estaban persiguiendo sus presas, todos los animales estaban aullando de miedo. Okay. While tigers were chasing their prey, all the animals were howling from fear. Perfect. So now, Joka, choose a number and choose a person.
Okay. Valentina.
Okay, Rocío. Mm-hmm.
Rocío, Valentina. Number 10.
10. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. We have to go down a little bit here. And it says, Rocio, the giraffes munch on leaves when a rhino appears. Do you know what is munch?
No, teacher. La jirafa, pero no.
Masticar, okay. Masticar.
Masticar.
Uh-huh. Y leaves. Do you know what is leaves?
Hojas.
Uh-huh. When a rhino, yes, hojas. Rhino es un rinoceronte. Okay. Aparece. So, how will be? Recuerda que está mirando lo que tenemos aquí.
Listo, teacher. Entonces, de giras, munching. Munching on the leaves when a rhino appeared.
Perfect. Very good. The giraffes were munching when a rhino appeared. So go ahead now, Rocío, your turn. Choose a number and choose a person.
A person. Danny. Yes.
Okay, and what number?
12.
12. So this is 10, 11, 12. This one, Danny. It says, the snake hiss while it glide along the path. Do you know what is a snake?
Serpiente.
Uh-huh. And hiss, do you know what is that?
No.
Es, hiss es el ceseo que ellas hace con la lengua, así como... Okay.
Como el sonido.
Ajá, okay. Exacto. El ceseo que hacen con la lengua, así. No soy capaz de hacerlo, pero así. Y glide. Do you know what is glide?
No, teacher.
Glide es el movimiento que ellas hacen en el suelo, arrastrarse, ¿ok? Que ellas se arrastran. Eso es glide. Along the path. Do you know what is along the path?
No.
A lo largo del camino, ¿ok? Along es a lo largo. Y the path, el camino. Ok. Mm-hmm. So, go ahead, Dani. ¿Cómo quedaría?
The snake was hissing.
Ajá. The snake was hissing.
While it was gliding.
Ajá. Along
the path.
Perfect. Very good. So now, Dani, choose a number and a person. Dato curioso, a sus lady no le han preguntado.
A sus lady.
So, if you want to. Okay, so sus lady. Wow, what a surprise. And what number?
16.
16. So this is 12. So 13, 14, 15, and 16. Here we have it. And it says, the vultures circle overhead when they spy a dead animal. So, Sus Lady, do you know what is vultures?
¿Cómo se pronuncia esto de parrot?
Parrots son los loritos, pero vultures son los buitres, ¿ok? Buitres, vultures. Entonces, por acá tenemos overhead. Circle overhead. Do you know what is this? Overhead?
Wow. I don't know, teacher.
Okay.
¿Sobre la cabeza?
Exacto. Oh, sobre la cabeza o encima del animal, ¿ok?
Bueno.
Y circle. Eso quiere decir que hacen un círculo por encima
de la cabeza.
De la cabeza del animal, cuando ellos spy. Do you know what is spy?
¿Espía?
Ajá, cuando espían a un animal muerto, a dead animal. Ok. So, ¿cómo sería este? Recuerda por aquí que tenemos este querido amigo. ¿Cómo sería?
Puedo utilizar esto, igual el pasado, el was.
Sí, pero entonces tienes que utilizarlo en la primera parte. En la segunda parte es utilizar pasado simple, porque estamos hablando con when, ¿ok? So, how would be? El verbo es circle, ¿ok? Ese es el verbo de la primera oración. So, ¿cómo sería? The vultures.
The vultures. Circle.
Where? Circling.
Circling.
Overhead.
Overhead when they spy a dead animal.
Perfect. Very good. So the vultures were circling overhead when they spied a dead animal. Very good. So now, Sus Lady, choose a number and a person. Una persona y un número.
La mía, ¿cuál era? Perdón. El mío era el 16, mi número.
Yes.
16. El 13.
Okay, so Dani, number 13. So this is 16. This is 15, 14, 13. This one.
13.
So it says, the zebras drink water while the buffaloes walk past.
Okay. The zebras were drinking
water
while the buffaloes was walking past.
Very good. Very good. Perfect. So now, Daniela, choose a number and choose a person.
Yoka.
Okay.
Six.
Six, number six. So let's see here. One, two, three, four, five, and six. It says skip four spaces. So one, two, three, and four. This one already... Rocío already did it, so we're going to put this one. This one, number nine. So it says, cheetahs flick their tails while look for food. Do you know what it is?
Show me, please. You can see
it. It's this one. Donde la naranja.
Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Okay. Chitas. Teacher, quita ese cuadrito de ahí que no puedo leer.
Ok, sorry.
Clicking there, don't look for food. Ok.
¿Sabes qué es flick? Ok, flick es dar un movimiento así súper sigiloso, la cola. Cuando mueven la cola, así.
Ok.
Como los gatos. No sé si has visto que los gatos mueven la cola así. Súper rápido. Ok, chitas.
One moment. Chitas. Chitas. Was flitting their tails while looking for food.
Okay, so
looking,
we have looking.
Cheetahs
where? Porque son varias cheetahs. Cheetahs where?
¿Y qué son las cheetahs, teacher?
Las cheetahs son como este animalito que está aquí, mira.
Como los gatos.
Es como una pantera, ¿okay?
Okay. Cheetahs were flicking their tails while looking for food.
Perfect. Very good. Cheetahs were flicking their tails while they were looking for food or while looking for food. Very good. So, this is the end, guys. Nuestro tiempo ya se acabó. Entonces, no vamos a preguntar más, okay? So, see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. This is the end of the class.
Thank you, teacher. Teacher, excuse me, una pregunta.
Yes, tell me.
Teacher, es que yo tengo una amiga que está interesada en...